got to hear that niggas always want to fight me first. See, I don't go out with niggas that like to fight, because then I'm going to have to be the nigga to fight, because when the fight about to start off, they always want to point me, it's this whole ass nigga right here. Nigga, nigga, look at that shit. Yeah, the nigga with the hell talking shit. Oh, me? It's just been like this my whole life. Yeah, six years old. Been crazy as fuck. Ain't got no brothers. Got a bunch of sisters, that's fine. So yeah, when niggas start talking about me, I just start knocking niggas out. I don't give a fuck. I'm swinging first. I don't know, you might just be talking about an argument. I'm swinging. And I realized, junior high school didn't work, because most niggas don't fight. Until you get to college. And you get the real world, that's where that first punch, most niggas don't know what to do after the first punch. You get hit, you be like, oh, that nigga tripping. Come on, Billo, you tripping, what's up, man? Nah, man, fuck you. Yeah. You get to college, that's when you start running for niggas that like to fight. And that first punch don't do shit to them. Yeah, figure that out. I'm in college. You know, I got a roommate, this nigga from Alabama. Yeah. Birmingham. Yeah. Yeah, so I got a test 8 o'clock in the morning. I tell him, hey, bro, tonight, I'm trying to study, trying to get him to sleep. You know, you got your 8-ball MJG a little too loud in there, bro. He one of them niggas, huh? Yeah, alright. 4:30, this nigga got all the 8-ball. 8-ball will come out hard. Yeah! So I go to my test, I'm hot. I'm sleepy. I ain't getting no rest. I don't think I did get on my test, so I'm hot. Yeah, I get back to that room. All right, bam, let me holler at you, bro. I told you could have gone down used to that. So what you gonna do, man? Oh, bitch, as soon as he said that, I pop! Yeah, nigga! He was like, ah. Oh, boy. And he smiled at me. Never have I stolen on a nigga and he smiled at me. That boy said, oh, boy, you got nuts, huh, boy? Didn't want to beat your ass. And for the next 10 minutes, this nigga made me touch everything in our door, bro. Nigga, I'm all in the closet. You know you get your ass whooped when you in the kitchen in the refrigerator. I'm looking at mayonnaise, mustard. Why is this nigga still hitting me? Stop! Because then I realized one thing. All my fights have been around other people. Usually somebody break this up. Nigga, ain't nobody gonna break this up. We ruined it. It's just us. This nigga's a terrorist. This nigga that took my phone. I can't call nobody. I called this nigga from 2:30 till 6:15. I was trying to wait and think I'm going to go in the room and just chill like the fight over with. Because normally when y'all leave the room, the fight's over. He won. I'm cooking some noodles. This nigga come in the kitchen. I'm still like, what you doing? Yeah, nigga, run it back. Run it back? You won. What the fuck? This nigga hit me. I got so much spice in my hair and my face, because he was whooping my ass when I had the packet open. So it's just, nigga, I come out of that goddamn house, you know, I got bullshit on. I got some loafers on, so I look like a battered bitch. People coming down the hall, because I'm hollering, help! Help, he's crazy! So, fucking RA come down there, what's going on? Like, we in a gay relationship. Trying to be a snitch, they talking about what happened.
No, we good, this my nigga right here. Right below